Tell me, Drew, how did you escape your darkness?
Senua, once I found my purpose, I was no longer enslaved to the suffering I had to endure to reach it. Unclouded by fear, I could see it clearly in others. Even my captors feared the fire of Surtr. And so, during one raid, I took my chance and ran, knowing that they would not follow. A fool ran into the fire. They left me for dead. Maybe they were right to. But here I am, free.
I'm glad I found you in the wilds. I wouldn't have made it without you.
Men say that what we see as a rainbow is the bridge that goes from the world of men to the world of the gods. For now, they say, the frost giants and the mountain giants cannot cross it. But they say that when Ragnarok comes, not a thing in this world will be safe. The rainbow bridge will break under the onslaught of the fire giants riding on flaming steeds. Senua, I have seen the fire of Surt spread far and wide, and to our lands. Ragnarok is coming. through the fire. Keep running. Go on. Nothing will stop. Run, Sam. Run, run, run. Through the fire.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. This darkness takes everything. Everyone.
Senua. Are you sure you want to do this? We can fight this together, side by side. We always do.
This is my battle. I have to face it alone. Away from here.
Where will you go?
I don't know.
For how long?
I don't know.
I believe in you. You know that. Just promise me that you will come back to me. I want you to say it. I want you to say it.
I will come back to you. I promise.
for every battle won, a greater battle takes its place. And so it goes. Until we fall. And in the end, we all fall. Even the gods have their time. Yet we still go on. Why?
I made a promise. And I will go to hell to keep it.
I die free, knowing you will carry my stories with you. I have fulfilled my quest.
Yes, you have.
When the darkness comes, I vow to guide you in this life and the next to fulfill yours.
Then I will see you in hell.
Be ready to face horror in the eye, as I have, to find your answers, your quest, your truth.
Druth was a troubled man, a scholar turned slave. They tortured him, took him with them on their raids, drove him to madness, spreading this new form of darkness to new worlds, to my world. Senua saw a deep connection form between the Northmen and the darkness. If his tales of hell were true, then that was the source of it. She learned everything she could from him, until she too could see what he saw. Have you ever died before? It's a serious question. When the illusion of self is shattered, you simply cease to be. Though it may not seem that way to others, you know when it is true. You can feel it. A stranger in your own body. An imposter. And nothing is the same ever again. Senua has died before. And she will do so again. You can be sure of that.
lives.
She's only passed one test.
What's the other test? Is there another one?
There must be. The gate won't open.
Druth said Valravn. Valravn. Dark magic.
Valravn. Druth said Valravn.
No, he didn't.
She needs to pass the test.
Valravn, ancestor of the seers and master of ravens.
There must be another
test. He hunts his prey with his powers of illusion and feasts on their remains. And defeat him in battle to earn his mark. The gate to Helheim cannot be opened without it.
Ymir was a frost giant, a being of darkness, and all his sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice, Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Bor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had three sons. Odin was the eldest, and the Northmen hold him to be the foremost of the gods, the All-Father. Illusion hides the path to Valravn. Don't trust your eyes. Find another way to see the truth.
What's that? It's a door.
Behind the veil, don't we? But once we do, we mostly just close our eyes again and pretend what we saw was never really there. Close differently. Because once you gaze into the relentless darkness, all that lurks within it can see you too.
Valravn's power of illusion comes from ravens. Align the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Druth.
Look over here. What can you see?
Look how much it's changed.
It's all different now.
Another world that looks the same but feels different. An imposter world where the forest itself is watching.
Do
Another gate.
Another gate? You know what to do.
Stay back.
You have to open it.
It's not safe.
Don't listen to them. Listen, listen. Don't open it. You can do it. Don't touch it. Stay back. Come on.
To break the seal, align the ravens with the mark of Valravn.
Who make it back are forever changed.
Thank you. She can get up now.
She can get up now.
What's happening? She can get up now.
She can get up.
It must be
magic.
Dark
magic. A trick.
Valravn. Tricking her.
Valravn.
How can she get up?
Bait.
It's him.
Dark magic draws her closer.
It's not.
He's helping her.
It's not him.
It's a trick.
She's doing it on her own. He's not tricking her.
It's magic.
It's an illusion.
Thank you.
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as walls.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything. Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
Reminds her of somewhere.
The forest.
Where? Which forest?
The forest in the wilds.
The wilds.
She left him.
She went to the wilds a long time ago.
Why did she go to the wilds?
She wanted to fight her own darkness. She thought she could beat her own darkness.
Did she beat her darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth. Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead.
She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillian.
She came to beat her own darkness and marry Dillian.
But it didn't work.
She thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him. She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too. She nearly died.
She thought the curse made her tainted.
Druth helped her.
Open it.
She can't. She has to.
Not from this side.
Northmen say you must sacrifice in order to receive. They tell how the runes were revealed to Odin only in sacrifice. He hung himself from the world tree, and he stabbed himself with a spear, and he dedicated the sacrifice to himself. For 9 nights he hung on the tree without food or drink, and at last he saw the runes below him. He gave a cry and gathered them in his mind and learnt them. Then he fell from the tree.